Next is Hendrik. And I can't even pronounce that. Over to you, Hendrik.
Yeah. Hello, everyone. So my lightning talk is Shiroyama, what 19th century Japan can tell us about modernization. So I personally love history and I love Japan. So I decided to do a lightning talk about history and more precisely Japanese history. And if the story seems familiar to you, it might be because you've watched the movie The Last Samurai, which is loosely based on this story. So I want to talk about a battle that happened on the 24th of September, 1877 in Kagoshima, Japan, and is called the Battle of Shiroyama. You see here a contemporary drawing of that battle. It was a final battle of a rebellion where the heavily outnumbered samurai made their last stand against the Imperial Japanese army. And it tells a story about tradition and modernization. So the actor number one in our story is Emperor Meiji, who was the 122nd emperor of Japan, according to the traditional order of succession. And he is considered the first monarch of the modern empire of Japan. He presided over an era of rapid change that witnessed Japan's transformation from an isolated feudal state to an industrialized world power. And we have another actor in our story, and you could see him as the antagonist of the emperor. And this is an image which shows Saigo Takamori's statue near the southern entrance of the Ueno Park in Tokyo. And he is considered one of the most influential samurai in Japanese history. He assisted in the Meiji restoration of Japan and he has been called the last true samurai. And our story concerns how he became an enemy of the country he helped to build up. So what is a Meiji restoration? So in the 19th century, Japan was afraid of being behind modern world powers, and there was threat and fear of being colonized by Western powers like the United States. And because of that, many samurai supported modernization in the beginning, leading to this so-called Meiji Restoration and the overthrow of the last shogun and transferring power back to the emperor. But years later, there was growing dissatisfaction with the direction the country was taking. The modernization of the country meant the abolition of privileged social status of the samurai class. Also, the very rapid and massive changes to Japanese culture, language, dress, and society appeared to many samurai to be a betrayal of the justification used to overthrow the former shogun, which was keep the Japanese culture alive. Also, the traditional way of samurai warfare was superseded by modern military techniques. Samurai are warrior nobles like knights in Europe, but modern military relied more on commoners who proved themselves and became officers. And also the samurai were skeptical of modern guns and artillery. So in face of that, Saigo Takamori wished to die honorably on the battlefield with his fellow samurai and asked the government to go to war with Korea in order to do so. After this was denied, he organized the rebellion against the government, relying on traditional samurai way of warfare. So on the left, you see the samurai, and on the right, the Imperial Japanese army. And now we can ask ourselves the question, did it go well? No. In the last battle, 500 samurai fought against 30,000 imperial soldiers. Samurai used mainly non-modern guns, swords, and bows, while the Japanese army used modern guns and machine guns. And Saigo was mortally wounded in the stomach and was carried by his best friend downhill to find a place to commit seppuku. His friend cut off Saigo's head and hit it to prevent it from being found by the enemy. After Saigo's death, his friend, now in command, charged downhill and was himself shot to death. Without any ammunition, the rest of the samurai drew their swords, charged downhill, and were subsequently killed. This is called Gyokusai, or Shattered Jewel, meaning honorable suicide. With these deaths, the rebellion came to an end. Emperor Meiji pardoned Saigo posthumously. Statues in Ueno Park, Tokyo, and near the ruins of Kagoshima Castle stand in his memory. Takamori was labeled a tragic hero by the people, and his actions were considered an honorable example of Bushido, way of the warrior, and Yamato Dashai, Japanese spirit. And what does this tell us? Don't insist that the old ways are always better. Don't be skeptical of modern tools. And honor is usually not a good motivation to do or not do something. So don't stick to the old ways. For example, use modern C++. Don't be skeptical of modern tools, for example, like something like an address sanitizer. And yeah, that's it. Thank you for listening to me.